In the last video, we talked about vertical asymptotes of a function in general, really of a graph, and this time we're going to do a particular kind of function, namely rational functions. So a rational function is the ratio of two polynomials. So here are some examples of rational functions. X squared plus 7 is a polynomial, 2x plus 3 is a polynomial, its ratio is a rational function. So is this, so is this. And we say that it's in reduced form if the numerator and the denominator don't have any common factors. So x squared plus 7 over x is in reduced form, but x squared plus 7x over x is not in reduced form because the numerator has x as a factor and the denominator has x as a factor. Okay, so how can a ratio blow up? Remember, a vertical asymptote is where the limit is infinity or minus infinity. So for a ratio to blow up, either the numerator has to blow up or the denominator has to go to zero. And if these are polynomials, the numerator is never going to blow up. Polynomials are nice and well behaved. So the way that you get a vertical asymptote is when the denominator goes to zero. Because whenever the denominator is close to zero, and the numerator isn't, then you have a ratio, a moderate-sized number divided by a tiny number, that's big. So for example, let's look at the function x over x squared minus 1. So when x is 1, the denominator is 0. Now, the function doesn't make sense. You can't divide by 0, so that's not in the domain. But you can ask what happens when you get close to 1. Whenever x is close to 1, x squared minus 1 is close to 0, and x over x squared minus 1, you know, is something really close to 1 divided by a tiny number, and that means a huge number. The closer you get to 1, the bigger the number is. There is no limit. We say it's infinity. The process doesn't finish. So for example, if you plug in 1.01, you do the arithmetic, you get about 50, a little over 50. You plug in 1.001, you get a little over 500. If you're on the other side, you plug in 0.999, you get about minus 500. So in fact, the function blows up to infinity from the right, it blows up to minus infinity from the left. And the same sort of thing happens when x is close to minus 1. Because if x is close to minus 1, x squared minus 1 is again approximately 0. So here's a picture of what the graph looks like. It blows up whenever x is slightly bigger than 1, f of x is gigantic. Whenever x is slightly less than 1, it's gigantic and negative. Whenever x is slightly bigger than negative 1, it's gigantic and positive. Whenever x is slightly less than negative 1, it's gigantic and negative. So the general rule is whenever you have a ratio, if the denominator goes to 0 and the numerator doesn't, then you get a vertical asymptote. Now, the statement "and the numerator doesn't" is important. Because let's take a look at the function x minus 1 over x squared minus 1. Where are its vertical asymptotes? You might think that they're at plus or minus 1, because that's where the denominator goes to 0. And in fact, when x is negative 1, you do get a vertical asymptote, because the denominator is 0 and the numerator isn't. But when x equals 1, both the numerator and the denominator are 0. And how do you deal with 0 over 0? Well, you cancel the common factor. If you look at x minus 1 over x squared minus 1, that's x minus 1 over x plus 1 times x minus 1, and you just cancel the factors of x minus 1. That makes sense everywhere except where x equals 1. So you get the function 1 over x plus 1 everywhere except where x equals 1, and this whole thing doesn't make sense at x equals 1 because it's 0 over 0. So the graph looks like this. It blows up in the when x equals negative 1, blows up positive when you're slightly bigger than negative 1, blows up negative when you're slightly less than negative 1. It does not blow up near x equals 1. It just has a hole, a place where the function is not defined. But it doesn't blow up. It does not have a vertical asymptote.